IVM.
In 2019, you basically have two choices. You can either go for therapy or start your own podcast. I'm Natasha Malpani Oswal, and this is my personal diary. I wrote a very honest poetry book called Boundless this year, where I poured my deepest and darkest fears into the poems. I'll take you through some of my favorite poems and the secrets behind them in this podcast. We explore falling in love, the dark side of beauty, families, money, making room to make mistakes, heartbreak, and finding your own voice. Don't say I didn't warn you. It gets deep. Today's episode is about loving yourself before you can love someone else. Slow burn. I begged you to slow down. I wasn't ready to hurt again. Too recently burnt. We flickered. Protecting myself from the flame, I melted. A slow burn. Into liquid, I sink. Quicksand. Pull me in. Delicate. I admire your fearlessness in love. I hold your heart in wonder. Don't you worry about being hurt? A beat. Hesitant. Letting you in is not easy. Pause. But I love the way you see me. I didn't believe in love growing up. I was never the sort of girl who dreamt of a fairy tale wedding or of being rescued by Prince Charming. Sure, I thought I would find someone and settle down. But I saw marriage as a practical thing, a partnership of equals. Given my very unromantic attitude, no one was more surprised than me when I actually did get swept off my feet. And let me tell you, I definitely was not ready for it. I completely resisted falling in love. And if my husband had not been a stronger man, I'm pretty sure it would not have worked out. But this is the thing that no one tells us, that the movies don't show us. Falling in love is hard, and it hurts. It requires letting yourself go and being open to pain. That's why it's called falling. It requires us to really see someone and allow ourselves to be seen. I think it's crazy that we talk so much about dating and how to find your soulmate, but there's so little out there in terms of learning to be with that person. I struggled with letting myself go and showing my weakest sides when I so badly wanted to impress my partner at the start. And then I struggled with letting him see how much power he had over me and how easily he could hurt me. In the end, I have to be honest, I loved being swept off my feet. But I'm also happy that I took the time to get to know myself first. Because to stay in love, you need to keep evolving with your partner. Like any other thing worth having, it requires constant attention and patience. Make sure that you love yourself first before you get ready to love someone else. Get comfortable with being alone. Make sure that you both like what you see when you're ready to be seen. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on our social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. And if you want to reach out to me, I am Natasha_Malpani on Twitter and at Natasha Malpani Oswal on Instagram. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Satyajit.
Hi, I'm Racheta.
We are from the Open Library Project and we host a podcast called Paperback.
Paperback is a podcast where we engage with stalwarts and experts from various industries, suggesting non-fiction titles that contributed to their journey in a big way.
We've had guests like Anjali Rana, Dr. Marcus Rani, Dr. Swati Lodha, Ambi Parmeswaran, Apurva Damani, and many more on our show Paperback. Find new episodes every Wednesday on IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you listen to podcasts.
Do you have a night routine? Well, everyone has one. And the to-do list usually looks like this. Brush your teeth, set that alarm, get into your pajamas, and switch off those screens. But here's one more to add to that list. Tune into the Positively Unlimited podcast for a dose of positive action and tips on how to build powerful mindsets. Episodes out every Monday on the IVM Podcast app, ivmpodcast.com, or wherever you tune into podcasts.